In this video, Barbara Tuss gives us a tour of her brooder room setup. Now here's Barbara.
Good morning. Welcome to my brooder room. Folks have been asking about brooding chicks, and I designed this room to be completely insulated under the floor, over top, and on the sides. All the walls are insulated. I can brood chicks in here year-round. Right now you're looking at my youngest chicks. They're about a week old, and they're in this first box here. I'm going to move a little closer. I've got right here, this is a water bottle, and it just lifts in and out. Then over here is the little gate that goes between them, and it just lifts out. And now there are two boxes now connected, and the chicks over here and the chicks over here are the same age. They've been raised together. I just had them separated for this video to start. This is one of the ceramic heaters that I use, and I like them. They're nice and warm for the chicks to get under. Moving around here, this is the second age group, and you can see one little chick in the doorway right there. Then I've got that doorway is open between the two, and then this doorway is open into the third box. All of these chicks in these three boxes are the same age. And let's see, right there you see the red wing clip in the middle of the page. That is one of my large fowl chickens. I raised both large fowl and bantam together. I band the large fowl with red and the bantams with blue. This right here, starting with that divider there on this side, these are the older chicks, and they're going to go out into the hen house soon. Now moving around the room here, I've got a workbench, and in this corner up above is a window. The fan brings cool air into the room from my shop. This window here is the exterior window, and the hot air goes out here. This brings daylight in. I have a lamp in the corner that I can use at night if I don't have enough light when I'm working out here. Then these two tiers of egg turners are used to store the eggs while I'm waiting to put them into the incubator or ship them out. Down below, in the corner, I have the feed. And this is, the first barrel is green. It's alfalfa meal. I use that in the baby chicks. The next one is pine shavings. I use that in the older chicks. The dustpan is 18 inches wide, and it allows me to scoop these boxes out very quickly and efficiently. It doesn't take me very long to clean them out. The automatic waterers, I have these little trough things here that go down to a drip bucket, because when these waterers fill, they also drip, and I don't want them dripping on the floor. Then back around here, I have a desk. It's an old desk. I just tucked it under here, and I have all kinds of little things stored in here. Things that you would normally use, like in a little office. Then up above, I've got storage on a shelf that is as tall as you, well, you can see the shipping boxes, how tall they are, and there's clearance there, about 2 inches of clearance above them. That shelf goes all the way around the room, and I like to keep 25 to 30 square inches per chick. That's a pretty good ratio, and it gives them lots of room to grow healthy. And once more, I'm going to back down here to the chicks. You can follow the boxes all the way around. This is a larger box. Underneath the blue is a gate between the two boxes, and those chicks can move back and forth. And then Oh, I've got one drinking here. Well, I did. Over here, there's one drinking. You can see how they just poke their little heads through that hole and they get their water. So the fresh water is very important for chicks. I like these drinkers. They're gravity flow and they're easy to clean, easy to maintain. If you have any questions, please feel free to email me. My email is barbtuss@gmail.com, and that's barbtuss@gmail.com. Have a great day.
Thanks for watching this APA video production. All rights reserved by the American Poultry Association, 2020.